Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to make a review of another Caveco Sport. As usual, I will try to make this short because I make reviews about almost every Caveco Sport I have in my collection. If I didn't do it yet, I intend to do. So I think there is no need to spend too much time on a review of basically the same pen, just a different finish, but I get excited with these and sometimes I talk too much. So let's start instead of just talking. This pen is, first of all, this pen was sent for review by Caveco. Thank you, Caveco. And this pen, because it is a Caveco Classic Sport, it comes in a paper package and it comes with this warranty leaflet that also has some instructions on how to fill the pen and with this silver sticker. Now the pen comes inside a paper box like this one, and inside it has this plastic bag sleeve. And put that away. And here we have the pen. And this is the Caveco Classic Sport Navy. And the navy is the new blue for the Caveco Classic Sport. This blue was released last year, so 2018. Since then, there was the classic blue, not navy, just blue, and it was around I'm not sure the date, and then it was discontinued, and it became discontinued for maybe 3 years, and now this navy came in. So first of all, let's talk about what is a Caveco Classic Sport. The Caveco Sport is a pen with this shape. It's a short pocket pen that gets in a full size when you post the pen. The Classic Sport means it is a Caveco made of plastic with gold trim that you can see in the golden medallion, the gold Caveco Sport inscription on the cap, and also with a gold plated nib. And this is it. Now let's take a look at some details. So the pen has this octagonal shaped cap with the Caveco logo in golden, as I told you, on the top of the cap. And you see many facets. In one of those, it says Caveco Sport. Then it has a little step down here on the bottom of the barrel. And then it has this knurled part. In the end, it says made in Germany. And it has a little spot, little dot, as you can see there, and that dot is just for them, for quality control purposes, for them to know which machine produced this pen if there is any problem. The cap unscrews, and I did a lot of turns, but it doesn't need that many turns. One full turn and just a little bit more than a full turn, and it uncaps. It has these threads for the cap to thread in. Then it has the nib, this typical nib that may be a Yovo or a Bock nib. And on the feed it says Caveco. Also, it has the Caveco logo on the top and the F nib for fine. It is a steel nib. And inside it takes cartridge short international cartridges or the short Caveco converters, which can be the piston type or like a narrowmetric type. And this is it. I want to show you the size comparison of this pen with two other well-known pens that I usually compare every pen I review with, which are the Parker Centennial Dufold and the Lamy Safari or the Lamy All-Star. And as you can see, The Caveco is much shorter when it is capped, that's why it is a pocket pen. But then, when you uncap this, and you usually don't use a Parker Dufold, Centennial Dufold posted, and when you uncap the Lamy Safari, because you, at least I wouldn't use a Lamy Safari or an All Star posted, when we compare them with the Caveco posted, we can see the Caveco reaches a full size pen. So, it's really appropriate for you to write with, despite being a very small pen when it is kept. The section has this hourglass shape. It is very comfortable to use. If it was a little fatter, it would be good, but this is a small pen, so you couldn't ask for more. If you don't like to hold the pen here, you may go up because these threads won't get in the way. You can use the pen and post it, but it depends on your hand size. Bigger hands won't be able to use the pen, or if you like to hold the pen higher, it will escape from your hand. So, this is made to be used posted. Now, let me take these away and show you the other one. And the other one is the Caveco Classic Blue. Now, this is hard to show because of the lighting I have, but I'll try to show you the difference. So, on the shade of blue, and it will be hard. Yes, it is very hard. As you can see, I think this is the navy. The navy has how can I describe? The navy is a darker shade of blue, but a real blue. And this classic blue is blue also, but it has more like a little purple shade. I can't really show you the difference in the video. It's not that easy to see. It is a little lighter and it looks a little bit more purple when you look at it in person. Here on the photo, you just can see the difference in the color between these ones. This is lighter and this is darker. The navy is the darker one, which is a nice blue. So now let's turn the camera and make the writing sample. And here we have our pen and our paper ready for the writing sample. And let me post the pen. I like to use my Caveco Sport Post-it, as I told you before. And this is the Caveco Classic Sport Navy. And the nib on this pen is a fine nib. The ink is the Caveco Royal Blue, which is a color that I think that matches quite well the color of the pen. And the paper is our usual Rhodia dot pad. And so, about the pen, as I told you, it is quite comfortable to use. It writes quite well. It usually doesn't skip unless I miss the angle to write with it, but it usually performs very well. There are people that complain about Caveco nibs being dry, but I never had. Okay, they are a little more on the drier side, but I never had a skipping Caveco nib, so I don't know. So it is not a problem. Maybe they are a little drier, but not skipping. I think many people like very wet pens. As you can see, it is not very, very wet, but it's wet enough to write with it in a very comfortable way and pleasant way. The nib is very smooth. Just a little bit of feedback, but not much. It is very consistent with the feel that I get from Caveco F and M nibs. The Extra Fine and Broad are not the same, but these are quite comparable, just the line width. I would say this is a normal European fine. There is no line, no natural line variation, and if you want some line variation, you'd have to press really hard, and even here, you won't see a lot of difference. Maybe just a little bit more ink being laid on the paper. About writing on the reverse side, usually Caveco is quite good in this. It becomes much drier, as you can see, but you usually can get a lot of sentences like this before the nib drying out, and sometimes it doesn't even dry out. I don't do it usually because I don't like to write on the underside of the nib. However, sometimes if I am drawing, maybe I want to use this lighter stroke to make some shading or something like that. So, and I'm keeping all the time saying so. This is it. I have to thank you in first place to Caveco for sending me the pen that allows me to make these reviews. And then thank you all for watching our videos. And if you liked it, please press the like button and keep coming for more videos like this one. See you next time. Bye.